In Inkscape, you can combine path effects. I select the text tool, and type some text. I will use Luckiest Guy, which is a free Google font. I go to path effects. I see that I need to convert the text to a path, to use a path effect. New in Inkscape 1.3 beta, is that you can do this now with a single click. So I click on Convert Text to Paths. From the menu, I choose Perspective Envelope. We will look at perspective in the next lecture. I select Envelope Deformation. I click on the Node tool. I can now drag the four corners to deform the shape. What I want is the end of the text to be smaller. So I hold Control and drag the nodes at the right end. Now I will add a second effect. From the menu, I choose Bend. I select Edit on Canvas. I can now curve the text. I can switch between the two filters to get the result I want. I can even change the order of the filters, which will change the look of the shape. When I'm happy with the shape, I'll finalize it by going to Path, Object to Path. I will make the text a bit higher. I call the path, Text. Now I go to Path, Linked Offset. I select the Node tool. I set the fill color to red. I drag the node up. I go to Path, Object to Path. I call the path, Red. I go to Extensions, Generate from Path, Long Shadow. I set Length to 5. I select the long shadow elements, and make them a single path with union. I call the path, Long Shadow. I remove the group folders. In Fill and Stroke, I make the red darker. And inside my text, I want a gradient. I choose Linear Gradient, and I select the Gradient tool. I make the gradient vertical. I set the gradient to yellow, and I make the top color more orange. I convert text to a clip group. Now I'll create a diamond pattern. I select the rectangle tool. I hold Control and drag a small square. I go to Path, Object to Path. I click on the square again, hold Control, and rotate 45 degrees. I go to Path Effects. From the menu, I choose Tiling. I set rows to 50, and columns to 150. And I increase the gap between the squares. I set Offset to 50%. I will leave the Tiling Path Effect editable. I call the path, Pattern. I set the opacity to 15%, and the blend mode to multiply. I drag the pattern on the clip group. I make the pattern smaller. I duplicate text and drag it on top. I shift click on white and click on the red cross to delete the fill. I make the stroke smaller. I call the path, stroke white. I duplicate stroke white. I call the original, stroke shadow. I shift click on black. In fill and stroke, I set blur to 10% and opacity to 75%. I hold alt and position the shadow. I duplicate red. I make the original pink. I call the path, pink. I position red on the canvas. I select the rectangle tool. I drag a rectangle and drag it on the clip group. I call the path, horizon. Now I will duplicate long shadow to make the shadow below. I call the copy, shadow below. I place shadow below on the bottom and click on black. And in fill and stroke, I increase the blur.